I'm Devin. I'm from Girl Scouts of Southeastern Michigan in the great state of Michigan. I'm a recruitment specialist with Girl Scouts. Imagine riding in a cool new car that can park itself and doesn't pollute our air. Now imagine it actually driving on the streets. That's what automotive design teams do. Automotive design is imagining and creating new cars and other vehicles. A vehicle is a machine, like a car, truck, or motorcycle, that moves people or things from place to place. Today, you're going to design a vehicle. The activity covers three of the steps needed to earn the new Brownie Automotive Design Badge. You can find full instructions for this activity on the Girl Scouts at Home page. It should take about an hour to complete this activity. First, have an adult help you print out the Brownie vehicle diagram and the vehicle design guide. Then, gather the materials for the activity. You'll need two or more large sheets of paper, one half of a small pack or more of white modeling foam, not foam beads, modeling clay or dough, some tools for sculpting, such as rolling pins, cookie cutters, dull plastic knives, or some hard materials with patterns, a pair of safety scissors, scrap paper, markers, and a pencil. If you have it, you may also want to use tracing paper to help you sketch out your vehicle. Part 1. Meet your customer. For this challenge, you're going to design a vehicle to help someone else. Creative designers are people who design new vehicles. They choose everything, from the color of the vehicle to the shape of the headlights. They design many different kinds of vehicles based upon what people do, where they live, and what they need to transport. Market research is when designers use interviews, surveys, and product tests to learn what kind of vehicle their customers need. For example, a designer might find out through market research that people want a vehicle that isn't too noisy, or they want a purple truck. Whatever the customer wants, a designer wants to know. To get started, look at the information about each customer for your automotive design challenge on the first page of the vehicle design guide. You have three options to choose from. Each customer has a special set of goals for the vehicle. You can design a mobile clinic for a veterinarian, a vehicle to transport sports teams and their equipment, or a mobile makerspace for kids. That's where people work together on projects with tools, technology, and other equipment. Once you've decided who you want your customer to be, check the box on the first page of the vehicle design guide. Then, pause this video to spend a few minutes thinking about your customer and how a vehicle can help them. Pretend to be your customer talking to a team of creative designers who are conducting market research. Ask yourself questions like, what do I need a vehicle for? Where am I going? Why am I going there? How many passengers will there be? What kinds of cargo do I need to bring with me? How fast do I need to get there? What do I like and dislike? For example, what's my favorite color? Ask yourself other questions that focus on how the design team can create a vehicle for you, the customer. Like, what would I want on the interior of the vehicle? What do I need on the inside? Or what do I want on the exterior of the vehicle? What do I need on the outside? Draw any ideas you have on a scrap sheet of paper. Part 2, create your design criteria checklist. How did it go? Do you have a better idea of what your customer wants and needs? I bet you already have some great ideas for your vehicle. All the information about your customer is data you can use to design a vehicle. Data is just another word for information. When you think about data and use it to make decisions, that's called data analysis. This is something creative designers do. They collect data through market research and analyze it to create criteria for their vehicles. Criteria are things a product, such as a car, needs to have. All vehicles need some of the same parts, like an engine and wheels, to make them move. For example, take a minute to look at the two criteria checklists in the vehicle design guide. These are lists of parts your vehicle needs to include. What parts do you see? According to the checklist, you need to include a steering wheel,
dashboard, seats, seat belts, and a gear shift for the interior or inside of your vehicle.
You also need to include axles, a body, bumpers, doors, headlights and taillights, a hood, a trunk, wheels, windows, windshield, and windshield wipers as parts of the exterior or outside of your vehicle.
Automotive design teams add other parts or design features that make the vehicle even more useful, fun, or different from other vehicles. For example, heated seats are great to have if you live in cold places. Cup holders and places to charge cell phones are useful for people on the move.
It takes an entire team of creative designers to create a vehicle. For example, the interior creative designer imagines what will go on the inside of a new vehicle, including the seats, steering wheel, and dashboard. The exterior creative designer imagines what will go on the outside of the vehicle, like the body shape, doors, windows, and wheels.
The color and trim designer chooses the color for both the inside and the outside of the vehicle. They decide upon the fabric or material used for the seats, and they choose any other special features for the vehicle.
Next, pause this video and add special features to your criteria checklist. Pretend to be each type of creative designer. Analyze the data about your customer and choose special features for your vehicle, adding them to the checklist in the vehicle design guide. As you create your criteria, don't forget to think about the data. Ask yourself questions like, what did you learn about your customer? What do they want or need? What could be useful for them as they move from place to place? Or what could make the ride more exciting?
Part 3, sketch your vehicle.
After creative designers have an idea for a new vehicle, they sketch many different pictures of it. They'll draw the exterior, the outside of the vehicle, and the interior, the inside of the vehicle. They'll draw the vehicle from above it, below it, and from either side. This helps creative designers to think about every part of their design.
For the next part of this activity, pause this video to use your imagination, criteria, and the vehicle design guide to sketch your vehicle. Be sure to draw both the interior or the inside of the vehicle and the exterior, the outside of the vehicle. If you need help or ideas to get started, please check out the tips for sketching in the vehicle design guide.
Part 4, sculpt your vehicle. How'd it go? Were you able to use all your criteria in your vehicle sketches? Automotive design teams have many different ways of creating models of their vehicles. They might create models digitally on a computer using technology like a 3D printer, or they'll create models with materials like clay or wood. Next, you're going to be a clay sculptor. That's the person on a design team who sculpts models of vehicles out of clay. So, pause this video and use your criteria and sketches to sculpt a model of your vehicle. Then, if you have time and the right materials, add color to your model vehicle with markers. If you need help or ideas to get started, check out the tips for sculpting in the vehicle design guide. And that's it. Once a designer has created a model, they can share it with their teammates. The team can then work together to look over the criteria, ask questions, identify any problems, and give ideas to make the design even better. When you make models and think of ways to make a design better, you're doing what a creative designer does. Being an automotive designer lets you use your imagination to create new vehicles. What was your favorite part of working as an automotive designer? If you grew up to be an automotive designer, what sort of vehicle would you design? Automotive designers create vehicles to help their customers. Who is another customer that you'd like to design a vehicle for? What problem could you help them to solve? You've successfully completed the 3 steps needed to earn the new Brownie Automotive Design Badge.
You explored how creative designers, including you, can create vehicles that solve problems and help people.
You know about market research and how to choose design features for customers.
You know how to create criteria, sketch, and sculpt a model to share an idea you have with others.
If you had fun doing this, you might want to continue designing and building vehicles with the rest of the Brownie Automotive Engineering 3 Badge Series. Thank you for checking out the Design a Vehicle activity.
If you like this video, please share it with another girl and reach out to your local Girl Scout Council or troop leader for more ideas.
And if you're not a Girl Scout, please join us. You can go on girlscouts.org to learn more.
Thanks for watching.